You know, when it first started, I was trying to figure out how are you going to tell a story that is so dark and graphic and violent with these figurines. And I was amazed at how you could become emotionally connected to these figurines and tell this horrible story about what happened to the Cambodian people. I became very emotional as I was watching it. I really became emotional when I saw the film of the school where they tortured people, because I was in Phnom Penh in December and I visited that museum now. So I became very emotional at that point in the film.
I think one of the things about death and loss is that we're afraid to tell the story. And I think something with the Khmer Rouge is the kind of story that where a lot of people think they've probably heard it already. But I think this is actually a reminder that we need to hear more stories, because there's more ways to tell the story than we've ever heard before.
This is the props from the movie. This is Rithy Panh himself. This is the original prop from the movie, the original claymation from the movie, and it was the gift from Rithy to me. It's just awesome.
I am preoccupied that the new generation of Khmer people do not know the story of the genocide, and they ask the question, and I have the responsibility to give them some response. You know, it's I do not like to make the film about that, but if you don't give response to young people, how they think about their grandparents, that their grandparents are coward, that their grandparents may be they are perpetrator.
Right.
I don't know why the grandparents are dead. And we have the responsibility to explain to them who is the perpetrator, who is the victim, and what did their grandparents. They resist, they defend their dignity, who they are. And you know, people feel better when they know the true story, and they can move forward. But if you don't want to tell the story, if you don't want to work on memory, you cannot turn over the pages.
In the middle of life, childhood returns. I seek my childhood like a lost picture, or rather it seeks me. I haven't been home since 1975, yet I remember every detail. These pictures are not missing, they are inside me. A memory, an idea that no one can take from you. For a picture can be stolen, a thought cannot. With clay and with water, a man is made. I spent my own childhood in film studios, then that world was destroyed. They dye our clothes black, they change our first names. There are no individuals, only numbers. This picture, I hold it in my hand like a beloved face. This missing picture, I now hand over to you.